So this is where we're at today with the dormer project. At this point, we have drywall up, as you can see. And the hardwood floors have been completely refinished. So the drywall work, blue board, plaster, and patching was all done by America Plastering, and the floors were done by Duffy Floors here in Medford. So, just a couple of things. We obviously had left some of the walls up. We didn't demolition all of the walls. Turns out that was probably not the smartest idea. Maybe save some money, not really sure. But what it definitely did cause was quite a lot of sanding effort and quite a lot of drywall mud effort. As you can see, there's still work to be done in terms of smoothing everything out before the baseboards go on and all the other trim. Another thing that was a consequence of us not replacing the floor in the bedrooms was that the original baseboard in this room, actually in both rooms, but most prominent in this room, the baseboard was actually in a gap next to the floor, which left a pretty big gap here. This is about an inch from the drywall, from this original drywall to the start of the hardwood floor. So as part of that, we had them actually fill this in with little pieces so that it would provide a better surface for the new baseboards to rest on top of. In the bedroom, in the master bedroom, this was less of an issue. We actually didn't really need to fill anything in here because this room has two layers of drywall. This was the original end with the house, and this was put on later. And that was enough to fill in the gap under most circumstances. One other thing that I just wanted to point out. So when I first came upstairs, so let's see, they started work on a Tuesday, and by today is Saturday, this is the first day that we can come up here. When I came up, I was initially very disappointed in the quality of the flooring. And the reason why is, as you can see in a number of spots, just kind of trying to find a good example here. It's just coming real close here. There's a number of very small imperfections, both in terms of little tiny bubbles, as well as gaps, breaks in the surface finish. Okay, I looked at this and I said, well, this is crazy, this is ridiculous. Why would it be so rough? Well, as I later found out, you're really only supposed to evaluate the quality of the finish of the floor under two criteria. One is standing as opposed to kneeling. And the second is not looking at the quality in the reflection, which will obviously show the imperfections quite clearly, but looking at the quality everywhere else. And as you can see from that criteria, the floors have to been done pretty well. There's a little bit of uneven staining, but I certainly will live with it. Now, the one thing that you do want to watch out for is either very large bubbles, which can be visible without from the standing position, or dirt, flecks of gunk. Now, this floor is almost completely devoid of that, with one or two exceptions. There was actually a spot sort of around here, I don't know where it went, I think it got trimmed off through you're walking. But there is another spot that you can just barely see as my toe gets close to it. Right there. And that's quite prominent in terms of this floor. Focus. That's a Mount Everest of dirt. Now I could obviously just flick this off with my finger, and I may do that intentionally or accidentally. It probably should be filled in. It might need to be filled in, especially if I feel like find any more. There's a couple more in this room where those are showing up. They show up as very tiny pinpricks on the screen, but you can sort of see them here. And what actually you can tell is that the finish has settled down and has mounded up around the sides of the dirt. Again, it's sort of hard to see on the screen, but when that clump of dust grit comes off, it'll leave a crater, which ideally, apparently, should be filled in. So that's where we're at right now. The next steps in the project are obviously painting, which none of this has been painted yet. Door installation, trim installation, and finish plumbing. So you'll hear more about that later.